after my traumatic first labor, whenever I heard women saying, oh, giving birth was such a positive experience, and no, I didn't really think it was painful, I wanted to physically hurt them. I hated them. So I want to apologize in advance if anyone wants to hurt me, because I've been there. I know that feeling. So please forgive me in advance. My labor from start to finish was only about 12 hours. I left my house at 5 a.m. in the morning, and I was back at 5 p.m. that day with my baby. So it was a very, very fast labor. So I was about 5 days past my due date, and I woke up one night about 1:30 a.m. and I was like kind of wondering, are these contractions? Am I feeling contractions? I wasn't sure. They weren't painful or anything. It was just kind of something I was feeling. So I started timing them, and they were every 9 minutes, and they were lasting 35 seconds. So I was pretty sure, okay, I think things are starting. So I woke up my husband and I just said, okay, I think it's, you know, this is my labor starting, but you know, it's gonna be pretty slow, I guess, so go back to sleep and I'll wake you up when it's time to go to the hospital. I probably could have gone back to sleep as well, but I was too excited and I wanted to keep track of my contractions. So I started watching Real Housewives and packing my last bits and doing my makeup and getting ready to go. So then at about 5 a.m., we left for hospital because my contractions were now, I think, just under 5 minutes apart. They weren't painful. Like, God, the contractions I had on my first labor were, like, on a scale of 1 to 10, they were a 10. These ones were kind of a 1. Like, I couldn't talk through them. Like, if I was in the middle of a sentence and a contraction started, I'd kind of stop speaking so I could kind of breathe through it. But it wasn't really sore, you know? So we got in the car and it was a 30-minute drive to hospital. And I just remember we were listening to Live and Thing by ELO on repeat in the car. Does anyone else get cravings for songs when they're pregnant? I get cravings for songs. On my son, it was Fortunate Son by Creedence Clearwater Revival. And on my daughter, this one, it was Live and Thing by ELO. So I was having my song on repeat in the car and I was singing all the way into hospital. And the only time I couldn't sing was when I was having a contraction. So I'd go from like singing at the top of my lungs to kind of just breathing through it. And then as soon as it was over, singing at the top of my lungs. So it was just such a different labor to my son. You have to watch the vlog of my son's labor because it couldn't be more different. So anyway, we get into hospital and I was really lucky. I got the suite that I wanted to. It was a really nice suite that had an ensuite and it had speakers so you could set up your music or whatever you wanted to listen to. I was practicing GentleBirth, which is kind of like Hypnobirth. So my husband was able to set up those tracks. So I was able to kind of have my GentleBirth tracks playing throughout the labor, which really helped me. GentleBirth is all about trying to make it a positive experience and relaxing and knowing that your body knows what to do and to try focus on the good times between contractions rather than the bad times of the contractions. So it just really helps to make it a positive experience and like not as stressful. So we got set up and I got my gown on and I hooked up my TENS machine. A TENS machine is a little machine that you connect with pads on your back. It sends mild electrical currents to control the pain. My midwife was amazing and she was guiding me and helping me change position every 20 minutes. So I'd go from one position bouncing on the ball to all fours on the ground to a different position on the ball. And it was just constant changing things. I think after a couple of hours, they decided to check me and see how dilated I was. And I thought I'd be a 4 or a 5. And I was actually a 0. I wasn't dilated at all, even though I was having proper contractions. So I was a bit deflated from that. But then they told me that because I wasn't dilated, that they don't consider that active labor, so that if another woman came into hospital in active labor, I'd have to leave and so she could get the room. So that just really messed up with my headspace. Like, all I could think about was, if someone else comes in, I'm gonna have to get dressed. I was in my gown, so I'd have to get my clothes back on, I'd have to take the TENS machine off, I'd have to pack up my bag, and like, that would have just been the worst thing, because things were going so well and it just would have disrupted everything. I kind of wish they hadn't told me that, because that just really messed with my headspace. I just lost it and I couldn't focus on the gentle birth anymore. So then I was really feeling the contractions and I was just stressing. So my husband talked me through it and he was finally able to get me back into the gentle birth headspace. So I was just focused on my breathing and focused on my body, and I just forgot about everything else happening outside. And luckily the next time they checked, I was 1 centimeter dilated, so I was able to stay in the room, and that stress was just gone, thank God. So then when I was 1 centimeter, they were like, okay, let's have another change of scenery. Now let's try in the shower. But I couldn't bring the TENS machine into the shower because obviously it's a machine, couldn't get wet. So I was a bit reluctant because I really felt like the TENS machine was helping me. But they were like, you know, we're gonna be here a while. It took you this long to get to 1 centimeter, so we're probably gonna be here a lot longer. So I took the TENS machine off and got in the shower, and I really started feeling the contractions then. I think the TENS machine was really, really helping me. So they gave me some gas, and I was breathing on that in the shower. And then I was like, wait, I think my waters went. I mean, I couldn't tell because there was water if I was in the shower. But I think I felt my waters go. So they were like, okay, well, your waters have gone. That's good. That's a good progression. And then like a minute later, I was like, oh, she's coming. She's here. And they're like, no, that's not possible. She's not here. And I was like, no, she's coming. And like my body just started pushing, and they were like, no, this is impossible. You were only just 1 centimeter. So they took me out and they put me on the bed, and they were like, yeah, you're fully dilated. Here we go. So it was really crazy fast. I think it was like 20 minutes from 1 centimeter to ready to push. It was weird. Like I didn't push, but like I just kind of sat back and breathed through it. And when it was time to push, my body did it for me. Like I didn't push. It was so weird. Like I can't really explain it, but my body did all the work for me. So my body started pushing whenever it was ready to. And I think there was only like 5 or 6 pushes, and I kept after every push, I was like, is she out? Is her head out? And they were like, no, maybe next push. And then next push, and I asked, is her head out? And they were like, yep, her head's out. And it was so weird because I did not feel a thing. Like I was feeling pressure down there, but I didn't feel her coming out. You know, people talk about, what's it called, the ring of fire. I didn't feel any ring of fire. I didn't feel anything. So then they coached me with the next push, and that I would have to push as well. So the next time my body started pushing, I join in and help a little bit more, because this was the big one. That was the only time I pushed through my labor. The rest of the time it was just my body. And then this time I pushed along with it, and she came out, and they put her straight in my chest. Of course, the emotional part. It was the best moment of my life, and you know, to fall in love so suddenly and so quickly, and it's so powerful. I can never talk about these moments without crying, but yeah, it was just amazing. And she was born at 9:32 a.m. and she weighed 7 pounds 15 ounces, and she was perfect. She had a little bit of meconium when she was coming out, but she didn't ingest any, and they weren't worried, so they just cleaned her up, and it was perfect. I was very relieved. I had an episiotomy on my son, which was a terrible recovery, so I was very pleased that there was no tearing or cuts or anything down there. I got in the shower and got cleaned up and got dressed, and I think we had to wait a few hours for the doctor to release us, and so we were just kind of waiting around in a little alcove of that room, and we were having tea and toast and cuddles with our baby and feeding her. And it was ready to go home. We went home, and it was just, as I said, it was 12 hours from us walking out the door. 12 hours later, we were walking back in with our baby. It was so positive. It was such a good experience. And like, I'd love to do it again. I know that sounds crazy, but I would. I'd like to do it again. And I never thought, after my first labor, I never in a million years thought I would have an experience like that. So I'm very glad. I got like 2 of the complete opposite ends of the stick, like the worst labor ever and the best labor ever. So that is my positive birth story. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more, please subscribe, and thanks for watching. Bye.